Hello, I'm Dr. Angelo Landresina, AKA Dermangelo. I'm a dermatologist and a skincare enthusiast, and I'm so happy to welcome you back to my YouTube channel. Today we'll be taking a deep dive on the double cleanse. I was so intrigued by the concept of double cleansing that I decided to comb the literature to find you all the data. And not just that, I tested it out myself. Today I will be your guinea pig. So let's get it started. Before we get into it, make sure you like this video and subscribe if you want to see more of my content. And also don't forget to follow along on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok, all at Dermangelo. Now, a word about my qualifications before we get started. I am a medical doctor. I have done biomedical research in the past, and I have a good working knowledge of chemistry, but I am by no means a chemist or a cosmetic formulator. So keep in mind, that's the lens that I'm looking at all of the data through. Okay, so what is double cleansing? At its most basic level, double cleansing is just cleansing twice. That could be something like a micellar water followed by a water-based cleanser, or something like a makeup wipe, followed by a water-based cleanse. But right now, the version of the double cleanse that's the most in vogue is the oil cleansing method. This is when you use an oil-based cleanser, like an oil cleanser or a cleansing balm, followed by a more traditional water-based cleanser. So why would somebody want to do this? A lot of the people that tout the benefits of double cleansing say that it's a more efficient method of removing makeup or sunscreen after a long day. They say that since many of the components of these products or even contaminants that come from the environment are oil soluble, they'll be better removed by that first oil cleanse. People also say that it's better to use two gentle cleansers rather than one harsh one in order to not irritate the skin. Now, the science behind the double cleansing method uses one of the classic concepts in chemistry, like dissolves like. So basically, polar substances, those that have a charge at each end, are water soluble, and nonpolar substances that don't have that charge are oil soluble. That makes enough sense, right? So when I first heard about this, I kind of laughed. Why? Because the whole concept of cleansing is that you're taking those oil-soluble substances and making them soluble in water through the use of surfactants. Surfactant is actually a portmanteau of the word surface active agents. They're one of the most important ingredients in cleansing. They allow those oil-based substances like sebum to be dissolved in water. To understand the way that they work, think about making a salad dressing. Your vinegar and your oil don't mix. They form bubbles within each other. Those bubbles each have an interface with surface tension. Surfactants have a polar head and a nonpolar tail, which allows them to line up along the interface of those substances, decreasing the surface tension and allowing them to mix. So this is how traditional water-based cleansers work. If you want proof, think about any harsh cleanser that you've used in the past. Think about how stripped your skin felt afterwards. That's because those surfactants allowed the oils in your skin to dissolve in water and they got washed down the drain. In spite of this, those that tout the benefits of double cleansing say that the oil-based cleanse is still going to dissolve those oil-based substances better, and they think that it's good for anything from dissolving makeup, sunscreens, water-resistant products, and even improving acne. Given this, I decided to look into the literature and see if there was any data about this double cleansing method. I specifically looked for any data about double cleansing's effect on makeup removal, sunscreen removal, or acne. Not surprisingly, there's not much data out there, but I did find one study that looked at oil-based cleansing versus water-based cleansing for sunscreen removal. This study out of Chengdu, China by Chen et al. Took 20 volunteers, had them apply different sunscreens, sit in a room and wait for 30 minutes, and either try to remove it with water alone, an oil-based cleanser, or a water-based cleanser. After this, they used the fluorescence of the sunscreen as a marker to see if it was removed. I'll list the products that they used here. Basically, what they found is that there was no significant difference between the effect of oil-based cleansing or water-based cleansing on the removal of non-water-resistant sunscreen. However, when they looked at a water-resistant sunscreen, they found that the oil-based cleanser was more efficacious at removing the sunscreen than the water-based cleanser. Their results seem to indicate that oil-based cleansing might be more efficacious at removing water-resistant products. However, you need to take all of the limitations into account. First, they only tested the products that they tested, so that means that their results might not be generalizable when talking about the use of all sunscreens or all cleansers. Secondly, their sample size of 20 volunteers isn't really that big. So for instance, when they were looking at the removal of the non-water resistant sunscreen, there actually may be a difference that you can uncover when you test more subjects. Thirdly, they only had the subjects apply 1 milligram per centimeter squared of sunscreen to their face. That's about half of the recommended dose. They said that they did this to mirror the way that people really use sunscreen. However, the conditions that they created probably aren't generalizable to the way that most people apply their sunscreen or how they live their lives. All that said, I decided that I needed to form my own opinion, so I committed to double cleansing every single night of June 2020. For my first cleanse, I decided to use a cleansing balm rather than a cleansing oil. I don't know, it's just me, but something about putting oil directly on my face makes me have acne flashbacks, and I thought that the cleansing balm texture would be more suitable for my skin. Based on many recommendations, I decided to go with Clinique's Take the Day Off Cleansing Balm. After this, I decided that I wanted to go in with a gel cleanser to make sure that I was fully removing all of the oil from the cleansing balm from my face. So I used La Roche-Posay's Telerian Purifying Foaming Cleanser. So my first time using this cleansing balm was not really what I expected at all. It has this really like wax-like texture. It doesn't come with any sort of a spatula or anything, so I just washed my hands before I dug in there in order to keep it clean. It does develop this sort of oil-like texture after it goes on the skin and absorbs the heat from your body. And then after I washed it off, I felt kind of stripped in a way that I wasn't expecting.
So first impressions right now, this is more of a squeaky clean feeling than I'm used to. Maybe even a little bit drier. I'm interested to see how this goes.
Now, did I see any difference in my skin after the 30 days? Surprisingly, yes. Around this time, I was wearing a mask at work all day, and I started to develop some clogged pores on my nose, some little sebaceous filaments sticking out. I wouldn't say that this is true acne or acne mechanica, but my pores did feel a little bit gross. I found that once I started double cleansing, the texture of that part of my skin did start to improve and my pores felt less clogged. Now, I just want to reiterate, there's no true data about the use of double cleansing for acne or maskne, but this is my own experience. So, in conclusion, there is no great data about the double cleansing method. The one study that did look at oil-based cleansing versus water-based cleansing for the removal of sunscreens seems to indicate that it might be better for removing water-resistant sunscreen, but we really can't extrapolate those results too far. Lastly, it might even be something to try for clogged pores based on my own anecdotal experience. My personal take: if you are a makeup wearer or somebody who uses water-resistant products on a daily basis, the double cleanse might be for you. In fact, even if those don't apply to you, double cleansing doesn't seem to be harmful in any way, so you could still try it out. I'm linking the products that I use for my own double cleansing regimen in the description below, and be sure to send me any other data that you might know of about the double cleansing method. If you like this video, make sure you hit the thumbs up. Also subscribe so that you see more of my content, and hit the notification bell so you get notified every time I upload. Ciao.